You may have heard that the US has implemented export controls on China for microchips. In October 2022, the Biden administration announced export controls to prevent companies from selling advanced semiconductor chips to China. The US wants to stop China from securing the kind of advanced chips that power artificial intelligence models and military applications. Not only that, but the US also urged its allies like Japan and Netherlands to stop selling machines and equipment necessary to manufacture those microchips. This move has shocked the world as Washington is using its power to prevent the rise of China through export controls. How China retaliates. However, Beijing didn't just sit back quietly. They came up with a clever strategy in response. They decided to pour a huge amount of money into mass-producing legacy chips, which conveniently weren't covered by the ban. The problem with the ban is that the Biden administration only restricts chips with 14 nanometers and below. China can still buy and manufacture chips that are 28 nanometers and above. And these chips, 28 nanometers and larger, are called legacy chips. You see, these legacy chips are still super essential, even though they might not be the latest and flashiest technology. They play a crucial role in so many things we rely on every day. From the smartphones that keep us connected to the electric cars that are shaping the future of transportation, and even the high-tech equipment used by the military, all of these depend on these unassuming legacy chips to work their magic. When the news about China is going to mass-produce legacy chips, it sparked fears among US and European officials. The US and EU are worried about China's drive to dominate this market for both economic and security reasons. Their concern revolves around the possibility that Chinese companies might release a flood of their older chips onto the worldwide market, similar to what happened in the solar industry. This could lead to foreign competitors being pushed out of business. China is the world's factory. And if the Chinese decided to mass-produce legacy chips, it will drive down the price of the chips, affecting global supplies and demands. In the solar industry, Germany was once the leader in solar panels and energy. However, once China entered the game, they mass-produced solar panels, driving the cost down, making solar panels affordable, and as a result, China has overtaken Germany as the world's number one solar energy producer. The West is afraid. Now, with the case of mass-producing legacy chips, the West is afraid the same thing could have happened with the semiconductor industry. If China dominates legacy chip production, Western companies may then become dependent on China for these semiconductors. As time goes on, this could potentially result in the emergence of fresh dependencies on supply chains based in China, either for the US or its partners. This situation, unlike the current state, could encroach upon the strategic independence of the US. The significance of legacy chips became evident during the supply disruptions that rocked companies during the peak of the pandemic, impacting even giants like Apple and automobile manufacturers. These chip shortages resulted in enormous financial losses, tallying hundreds of billions in missed sales opportunities. Modest yet vital components, like power management circuits, play a pivotal role in a variety of products, spanning from smartphones and electric vehicles to critical military equipment such as missiles and radar systems. To lessen their dependence on Asian markets, both the United States and Europe are actively working to bolster their domestic chip production capabilities. Governments are allocating public funds to support local chip factories, with initiatives like the Biden administration's substantial $52 billion commitment through the CHIPS and Science Act. These efforts aim to fortify their own chipmaking prowess and enhance self-sufficiency. However, Western chip manufacturers may be reluctant to invest in facilities because that means they will have to compete with heavily subsidized Chinese plants. Chip war, who will win? After the Biden administration announced the export controls last October, Chinese firms are on the move to construct new manufacturing plants faster than anywhere else in the world. According to a study, China is going to build 26 fabs through 2026 that use 200mm and 300mm wafers. On the other hand, the US only has 16 fabs. Substantial investments have enabled Chinese companies to continue providing the Western markets with their products, even amidst escalating tensions between Washington and Beijing. It's an irony that China's leading chipmaker, Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corp., SMIC, managed to secure roughly 20% of its sales last year from clients based in the US, including Qualcomm, despite finding itself blacklisted by the American government. Apart from that, TSMC, the largest semiconductor manufacturer in the world, which was based in Taiwan, decided to invest $40 billion and build factories in Arizona, US, after Joe Biden announced the CHIPS Act. TSMC wants $15 billion in government aid for its US chips plant. Yet US government money also comes with stringent conditions on its recipients, which TSMC is resisting as it starts work on its two Arizona factories. And just recently, TSMC has decided to postpone the opening of its Arizona factory, resulting in a one-year delay, pushing the launch of its first US plant to 2025. The primary reason behind this delay, according to the world's largest contract semiconductor manufacturer, is the challenge of recruiting sufficiently skilled workers to ensure a timely opening. TSMC said they are working to improve the situation by sending experienced technicians from Taiwan to train the local skilled workers. However, this plan took an unexpected turn when a prominent construction worker union retaliated against TSMC's assertion of a shortage of skilled labor for building its Arizona facility, deeming the claims as offensive. In the race for semiconductor supremacy, an intricate power play unfolds. China's pivot towards producing legacy chips, immune to the ban, showcases its agility in circumventing restrictions. Western powers responded by fortifying domestic production to maintain autonomy. As China speeds ahead with manufacturing plants and fabs, the West grapples with challenges like skilled labor shortages, highlighting the intricate dance between infrastructure and resources. The semiconductor battle becomes not just technological but geopolitical, with chips as the new power currency. The West responds with efforts to bolster domestic production, but can they match China's determination and ingenuity? As the chips fall, who will emerge as the true master of the semiconductor realm? Tell us what you think by sharing your thoughts and leaving your comments below. If you like what you watch, hit the like button to show your support. More importantly, subscribe to this channel so that you will continue to receive interesting videos about the happenings in Asia.